God, I'm so happy, bro, that you thought about accepting Islam, man. It really warms my heart, bro. We've been talking for how long now, bro? I've never even met you, man. But yeah, bro, in Jannah, right, which is paradise in Islam, bro, we're going to have everything that we... Excuse me one second, I'm kind of hungry. My biryani! Give me the biryani! Sorry, bro. Yeah, bro, in Jannah, in paradise, bro, we're just going to have everything that we could ever want and desire, bro. It's just... It's going to be crazy. And guess what? The women, bro. Oh my God, bro. The women in paradise, bro. It's going to be crazy. Man. It's and bro, it's really simple to accept the Islam. Really, really simple, bro. You just have to say these few words I'm going to teach you, bro. And you... What? Mom! Give me the goddamn biryani! I'm hungry! Sorry about that, man. Yeah, bro. It's simple. You accept... You say these words and you just become a Muslim, bro. It's really, really straightforward. Really simple. It's not even a problem, bro. And guess what? When you become a Muslim, all your bad deeds are forgiven and God converts them into good deeds, right? So you are actually better than a lot of Muslims who actually are like born Muslims, bro. It's pretty dope, right? That's what just give us a my mom, bro. It's just one really important concept in Islam, bro, and we really focus on Islam, bro, is respecting our parents. So please, bro, you gotta, it's one thing, as a Muslim, we gotta respect our parents.
Way of Life SQ, keeping it 100.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I cannot begin to explain the gratitude that I have towards Allah who sent you to this channel to watch this video here today. Ladies and gentlemen, you cannot make this type of stuff up. This former atheist right here joins a mobile game innocently, not expecting to have her entire life turn upside down. She joins this game called the Game of Sultans, which some of you probably already play. And to be honest with you, my wife actually plays that mobile game. Sister Zahra's perspective, like many others about Islam, was all portrayed negatively from the media. Sister Zahra never thought positively of Islam and thought that Muslims were all terrorists. And of course, the Muslim women were oppressed because they're wearing their headscarf on their heads. Until one day, Zahra actually meets a Muslim. Well, technically, she never really met her, and that's the cool part of the story. In comes Sister Kim, the savior of all aspiring Muslim Twitch streamers and gamers, showing you that dawah can actually take place on the online realm, especially as a gamer, which she happens to be. Sister Kim sees a noob on the gaming Discord, approaches her immediately, gets her phone number, gets her address, sends her some Qurans and some reading materials, and then adds her in a WhatsApp group and just sends her a whole ton of Muslim videos to give her dawah. And then guess what? Sister Zahra becomes a Muslim. She accepts Islam. Takbir!
Sorry.
Only an idiot would give dawah in such a generic, non-personal way. But Kim is a dai genius because Kim did something that a lot of us fail and forget to do. She befriended Sister Zahra.
Astaghfirullah, being friends with kuffar is haram.
Sister Kim befriends Sister Zahra on this online Discord, and before you know it, they became besties. And then eventually, through time, through patience, the conversation of religion came up. Sister Kim shared with Zahra her religious beliefs and created, and this is the most important part, and Sister Kim created a safe space for Sister Zahra to ask any types of questions without them sounding ignorant, racist, or offensive, to ask Sister Kim any type of questions that she might have about her faith. And that's what unlocked everything and changed Sister Zahra's life. Sister Zahra asked Kim a whole ton of questions in which Kim masterfully answered the questions in such a peaceful and patient manner. Until the question of hijab came up. No, not that hijab, this hijab. Now Sister Zahra, like many non-Muslims, view hijab as something oppressive. So she asks Kim the question about hijab and why she wears it. And this is what Kim stated. When a woman covers up, it becomes about people getting to know her for who she is and not the way she looks like. Can we just pause for a second to appreciate how wise those words are, especially in a time where every other day we're hearing of some famous popular influencer taking off her hijab and people feeling like they used and abused the Muslim community, promoted a modest clothing line, sold their hijabs, and eventually took off the same product that they are pushing out to the people. Even non-Muslims are seeing the beauty in the hijab, and honestly, that's just a breath of fresh air.
Smells fresh.
Sister Zahra immediately vibed with that, and with some time, patience, and of course, the guidance of Allah, the rest was history. This brings me to you guys, and sometimes watching the internet and looking on YouTube videos, and you see these giants in the dawah game on Speaker's Corner doing their thing, these OGs on the stage talking, these awesome YouTubers giving dawah to the public, and sometimes this can look very intimidating. But I want you all to realize that you all are da'is in your own capacity. Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us to relay and convey the message even if it's just one verse. So you don't need some type of certification or some type of qualifications to give dawah. You need to be someone who is genuinely interested in Islam and loves for your brothers and sisters what you love for yourself. You are a da'i to your colleagues, to your classmates, to those you interact with in the real world. And the secret sauce that Sister Kim used is something that we all need to apply in our own lives, and that is befriending people. People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. So it's our responsibility to show the people that we care immensely for them, because that's when they really start listening to us. Let me know in the comment section below, how do you prefer to give dawah to those who are in your life at the moment? I would love to learn and hear from you your strategies on how you give dawah. And of course, before you go, if you could possibly please just do me this favor, make the intention tonight when you go to sleep to wake up in the morning and fast. And after you fast, if you could just stay in itikaf with that intention for about 2 to 3 days, and after you sit down reading Quran, fasting, and you are in itikaf making a ton of dua for the ummah, I want you to get out of itikaf, and then I want you to smash that like button. I appreciate you so much. If you'd like to watch more videos with me, please click any one of these videos right here. If you're new to this channel, it'd mean the world to me if you subscribe by hitting this button right here. And until next time, I'm out.